Hey guys, here with my muzzleloader to try out some these cool ARX bullets here. Let's see how these work. They're a polymer bullet with some form of copper powder blended up in them. And these are what I have been using in my muzzleloader so far. It's a Acura CVA muzzleloader, and yeah, this will be interesting to see how these work. So let's get to it. Okay, so the muzzleloader is topped off with the Vortex 1x24, basically no zoom at all, and I have a Bagara barrel on it, 50 caliber. Acura MR model. So let's get it loaded and see what it does at 50 yards. Alright, so this is, what is the camera thing? The little polymer copper bullet. So we're gonna see how this thing wedges down inside of this barrel. The actual 50 caliber. So let's see how it goes. Got this cool little CVA bullet starter. This is the first time I've actually used this thing, so I'm no professional at it. But let's see how it goes. Let's pull this out of the way. Boy, they start a lot easier than the Hornady. Around, that's for sure. Probably be a pain in the ass to clean out of there later, though. Or at least that's my guess. You always hear about the polymer stuff, like the Sabo rounds and that, needing a whole lot more cleaning because they leave plasticky residue in the barrel. So. That's not seated. We're in trouble. But it should be. And just using 100 grains of 777 stuff here. So let's see how she goes. I'm gonna put on some hearing protection before I put the primer in there. Because I don't feel like going deaf anytime soon. Already hard hearing enough as it is. So see how she does. Alright. So now we need primers, and I don't spend the money on the 777 brand muzzleloader primers. I think that's goofy when you can get just ordinary shotgun primers. These guys here, just 209 shotgun primers for maybe half the price or less. I'm not sure. I can't remember how much I paid for these as opposed to what the others run. A little bit cruddy looking on some of these things. Alright. So. Alright. Helps take these caps off. Let's see how she does. Let's turn this so you guys can get a little muzzle blasty action here. I'm not on a bench rest, so these are not going to be like flawless, perfectly accurate shots. That shit's smoky as hell. Alright. Let's clean this puppy up real quick and see how she does for round two. I was actually aiming a little bit over the target when I squeezed the trigger, so most likely, yep, is right above the target. I'll show you guys when I get down here.
That's where
I shot. That's pretty much about where I was aiming. So,
can't see through that hole. Pretty interesting. I landed back there, it looks like, right up here somewhere. That thing's probably wedged in there real good. So, won't be finding that puppy ever. That actually went through the, oh no, it didn't. It just missed the wood backer there. So, let's go see what else we can do with it. It looks like windage is really good. So, let's actually put the sight on the little green bullseye here as best we can and see how that goes.
See the big smoke plume. That's a lot of smoke. Now I'll aim like about 6 inches under the target and see where that goes. Yeah, it's a lot of smoke. All right, so testing out the polymer / copper polymer style bullets, and this is where I hit with those, the four that I did. This one here, I was aiming down here somewhere. So these ones, I was actually aiming at the target here. And need to do some work if I want to hunt with those, because my gun's actually set up to shoot the Hornady that I was showing you. And just to see where maybe the scope or something had gotten out of whack since I'd fired it last. So I put one of the Hornady rounds in, and my gun is happily shooting those. So I don't know, I mean, it's not a super conclusive review. I mean, still a grouping that size, that's pretty good, darn good. I mean, I don't know, what is that, like a 1.5-inch group or something like that. Not too shabby for those. So I would say they're pretty good. They definitely have a heck of a lot less recoil to them. When I shot this guy, my shoulder is actually a little tender after shooting that one, because they kick a good bit more. So, I mean, if you want something that is accurate and, you know, doesn't have as nasty a kick to it, the polymer bullets definitely do the job, and I'm sure they would most definitely take down, you know, white-tailed deer or something like that. Those are my opinions on them. Overall, I think they're a really good round. So I might come out again here and tune my sights in to shoot the polymer-style bullets and give them a try for this year's hunting season. Plus, I don't want to put a a bunch of lead into something I'm planning on eating if I get anything. So that's my conclusion. You guys have a good night. All right, bye. Come on, man. It ain't like I'm a swinging on my block.